Very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today is Simon Cawkwell, famous in the investing world for spotting overvalued stocks and shorting them. So we'll learn more about your strategy today. Of course, the author of Evil's Good, book of boasts and other investments as well that you wrote some years ago now. So we will talk about that too. But first of all, a very good morning to you, Simon. Thank you for taking the time to speak to us. And maybe let's kickstart by you telling us all about your methodology, if you would.
As you know, I write on Master Investor typically once a week. And if there is a theme, it is that I'm very concerned to see asset backing on a stock. And that has served me very well. Occasionally, I take a flyer when I'm impressed for some other reason. For instance, since you raised the point, ADVFN have come up with an announcement this morning that there are people stalking the share register. And whilst they stress that ADVFN have not had a takeover approach, I think, to judge by their appointment of brokers and financial advisors, they clearly think they might get a bid from somewhere, which, of course, I must stress, is not the same thing as that they will get a bid from somewhere.
And Simon, is there a point in time in your career where you've maybe gone short and maybe got it all wrong?
Oh, yes, certainly. Oh, yes, that's undeniable. It can be very exciting when that happens.
Exciting?
Yes, that's it. One might say it's the moment when it's a moment for exiting. But anyway, the fact of the matter remains that that can, of course, happen. I was feeding, shall we say, on Regis, which has changed its name now. I think it's to IWG or something like that. But I overdid that. And when it turned round, I lost £3 million in a few minutes. And I remember thinking that was quite quick. But the answer to that is that can happen. But then I just closed the position. I took the loss, which I'm sure was the right thing to do in the light of subsequent events.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, you have been hugely successful, though, and made enormous amounts in really short periods of time. What would you say is your sort of biggest coup of all, would you say, Simon?
I may say that early in 2021, I took a swing at what is now known as quantum blockchain technology. But how that came about was not through any assessment of net asset value, save that I thought the accounts were misleadingly pessimistic. I took the view that the boss of quantum blockchain, a chap called Francesco Gardin, who's an Italian professor of IT, I took him to be both honest and very intelligent. And then I said, right, this time we'll have a go for him. And I did, and it was a very successful attack. That can happen, you know. And of course, the point is that one is meeting the people, whereas there's a school of thought which says one should never meet the management of a company on the grounds that they may confuse one's thinking. But on this occasion, I wasn't confused. And the gamble came off. There was a few million quid there. But anyway, the fact is that there was no guarantee that that would happen at all. It just happened.
Why do you think most private investors prefer long-only strategies, though?
Because they're stupid. It's a very silly way to think about things, to deny half the action in the market. And it's just foolish. When people say that as a matter of principle, they won't go short, then, in my opinion, they are being outstandingly ignorant and stupid.
And without giving advice, is the NASDAQ a short play at the moment, would you say?
Oh, good heavens. I've been wrong on this now for the last 12 years. I've lost track of it. But I personally think there are so many stocks that are ridiculously overvalued in America that it's extremely dangerous to go buying stocks in America. But they still keep going up. This valuation of Tesla, to take one prominent example, is completely and utterly mad. That doesn't stop its going up, you know.
So
perhaps it starts going down this afternoon. We'll call it the Katie moment.
Oh, that would be good, wouldn't it? Yeah. Yes. Well, hopefully I'll make some money. That would be good. Simon, what is your biggest tip of all to a novice investor, would you say?
Right now.
Right now.
God, you are tease. I would say, my NAP for 2022 is REA Holdings. If this were a company operating in this country, I would unhesitatingly say it's a doubler from here. It's about 150 pence without a moment's hesitation. But it's situated in Indonesia, and you've got the ecologists going around making silly remarks. I in that group, I include, I'm sorry to say, Sir David Attenborough. But anyway, then the other problem, which is the most important problem, is that the Indonesian government can be difficult. In the long run, they have a taxation policy, which I do not think will work to their advantage. But anyway, it's their country, they can do what they like. But that's the risk factor on REA. I don't think the underlying trading position is dangerous.
Well, Simon, pleasure to meet you. Thank you very much indeed for sort of letting us dig into your brain this morning here on Proactive. Simon Cawkwell, thank you.
Thank you very much.